भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
भगवत गीता एज इट इज चैप्टर नंबर 7 वर्स नंबर 28। चैप्टर नंबर 7 इज नॉलेज ऑफ द एब्सोल्यूट। ओके प्लीज रिपीट आफ्टर मी। येषां त्वन्तगतं पापं
येषां त्वन्तगतं पापं
जनानां पुण्यकर्मणां
जनानां पुण्यकर्मणां
ते द्वन्द्वमोह निर्मुक्ता
ते द्वन्द्वमोह निर्मुक्ता
भजन्ते मां दृढव्रता
भजन्ते मां दृढव्रता।
येषां त्वन्तगतं पापं
येषां त्वन्तगतं पापं
जनानां पुण्यकर्मणां
जनानां पुण्यकर्मणां
ते द्वन्द्वमोह निर्मुक्ता
ते द्वन्द्वमोह निर्मुक्ता
भजन्ते मां दृढव्रताः
भजन्ते मां दृढव्रताः।
येषां त्वन्तगतं पापं
येषां त्वन्तगतं पापं
जनानां पुण्यकर्मणां
जनानां पुण्यकर्मणां
ते द्वन्द्वमोह निर्मुक्ता
ते द्वन्द्वमोह निर्मुक्ता
भजन्ते मां दृढव्रताः
भजन्ते मां दृढव्रताः। येषां त्वन्तगतं पापं
येषां त्वन्तगतं पापं
जनानां पुण्यकर्मणां
जनानां पुण्यकर्मणां
ते द्वन्द्वमोह निर्मुक्ता
ते द्वन्द्वमोह निर्मुक्ता
भजन्ते मां दृढाव्रताः
भजन्ते मां दृढव्रताः। Anyone else would like to chant?
येषां त्वन्तगतं पापं
येषां त्वन्तगतं पापं
जनानां पुण्यकर्मणां
जनानां पुण्यकर्मणां
ते द्वन्द्वमोह निर्मुक्ता
ते द्वन्द्वमोह निर्मुक्ता
भजन्ते मां दृढव्रताः
भजन्ते मां दृढव्रताः। The translation in purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Persons who have acted piously in previous lives and in this life, and whose sinful actions are completely eradicated, are freed from the dualities of delusion, and they engage themselves in my service with determination. Purport. Those eligible for elevation to the transcendental position are mentioned in this verse. For those who are sinful, atheistic, foolish, and deceitful, it is very difficult to transcend the duality of desire and hate. Only those who have passed their lives in practicing the regulative principles of religion, who have acted piously and who have conquered sinful reactions can accept devotional service and gradually rise to the pure knowledge of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Then gradually they can meditate in trance on the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That is the process of being situated on the spiritual platform. This elevation is possible in Krishna consciousness in the association of pure devotees, for in the association of great devotees, one can be delivered from delusion. It is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam 5.5.2 that if one actually wants to be liberated, he must render service to the devotees. Mahat sevam dwaramahur vimuktehe. But one who associates with materialistic people is on the path leading to the darkest region of existence. Tamo dwaram yoshitam sangi sangam. All the devotees of the Lord traverse this earth just to recover the conditioned souls from their delusion. The impersonalists do not know that forgetting their constitutional position as subordinate to the Supreme Lord is the greatest violation of God's law. Unless one is reinstated in his own constitutional position, it is not possible to understand the Supreme Personality or to be fully engaged in his transcendental loving service with determination. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnana Anjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Melitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Mukam Karoti Vachalam Pangum Langhayate Girim Yat Krupatamaham Bande Shri Gurum Dinatarinam Paramananda Madhavam Shri Krishna Chaitanyam Ishwaram Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Preshthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindubhya Evacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Okay, so we are on the seventh chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, Knowledge of the Absolute. Krishna has discussed many different things in this chapter. He told Arjuna at the beginning that he is going to tell him this transcendental knowledge, but this actually is going to tell him about this process of yoga. And this yoga is not the yoga of, you know, performing just asanas, exercises, but this is much, much superior yoga. And what is this yoga? Does anyone remember? Does anyone remember the type of yoga that Krishna is teaching in this particular chapter? Yogam yunjan madashrayaha. This is the yoga of taking shelter of Krishna. Okay, so this is very important yoga. We can never be successful in yoga without taking shelter of this Vishesha Purusha, this very special personality who is Krishna, Bhagavan. When we engage in this yoga of madashrayaha, taking shelter of Krishna, by engaging the mind in Krishna, this yoga is performed. And this is very powerful yoga. Through this yoga, we can understand Krishna. He also said he is going to give knowledge, the phenomenal and numinous knowledge. Not only just knowledge, but also practical application of this one. And so powerful that by knowing this, nothing else is not known. Everything is known. There's nothing else to be known. But however, in order to know this, we have to have, how can we approach this yoga? That's why he said, amongst many thousands of people, manushyanam sahasreshu kaschid yat siddhay. Out of thousands of people, one may endeavor for perfection. And amongst those who are endeavoring perfection, only few will know Krishna. So having said that, he started giving knowledge about himself, particularly by saying how everything is. He's the source of everything. Earth, water, fire, air, ether, mind, intelligence, ego. These are different material elements coming from Krishna. Not only that, the living entities are also coming from him. And in verse number 7, he declares that mattaha parataram nanyat, na anyat. There's nothing superior to Krishna, even little bit. There's nothing superior to Krishna. Everything is dependent upon him as pearls are strung on a thread. Just like the pearls are taking shelter of the thread to be able to be in the right position, everything, all the material energies, they're able to conduct themselves because Krishna is beyond them. Sorry, Krishna is support for all of this. Krishna is behind all of these things. Of course, he's also beyond, but what I meant to say is he is behind all of these things, and he's keeping them in the right position. And he gave a few examples that he's the taste of water, vibhutis, his opulences, he has described through several different verses. And he also talked about the material energies. And he said it is not possible to conquer these material energy if we do not surrender to Krishna. Mama Maya Duratyaya. But Mameva ye prapadyante Maya metam tarantite. Those who surrender unto me, they can overcome this Maya. The three modes of material nature, they bind us to this material world. Mohitam. The entire world is moha. Now pay attention to this word moha. Okay, the whole world is illusion. Why are we in illusion? Because of this moha. This moha itself is illusion. So we are in illusion because of the three modes of material nature. Okay. Sarvamidam jagat. This entire world, entire universe, entire creation is bewildered by these three modes. But Krishna is beyond the modes. And if we want to surpass these material modes, we have to take shelter of Krishna. Mameva ye prapadyante. So now having described that I am going to give this wonderful knowledge, and in this knowledge you have to take shelter of me. Everything is coming from me. And there's something called three material modes in this world. And those who take shelter of me, they can overcome the modes. So this is the yoga. The yoga is to prapadyante, mame vaye prapadyante, maya metam tarantite. The yoga is to take shelter of Krishna, yogam yunjan madashrayaha, in order to get out of this moha created by the three modes. Then he talked about those who do not surrender unto Krishna. They are fools. They are atheistic. They are the lowest of mankind. Their intelligence is stolen by Maya. These people do not surrender to Krishna. That mameva ye prapadyante maya metam tarantite. But there are certain people who na prapadyante, do not surrender. And they will never get out of Maya. And those type of people are described. And instead of yogam yunjan madashrayaha, they take ashrita of asuram bhavam, atheistic nature. And then he talked about different types of people who surrender unto him. Chaturvidha bhajante mam jana sukritino arjuna. And these are called sukrutis, whereas the previous people are called dushkrutis. And sukrutis surrender unto Krishna. But amongst them, That person who is in proper knowledge and who is always engaged in the service of the Lord, Krishna says he is the topmost person. He said all of them are good, but that person who is in knowledge, engaged in my service, he is considered to be the best. And those amongst people who are jnanis, not yet bhaktas, those who are seeking for knowledge, and they, after many, many lifetimes, they also surrender to Krishna, because that is the goal of knowledge. The goal of knowledge is to, ultimately, if someone is seeking knowledge in a sincere way, eventually they come and they surrender to Krishna. Again, the point of prapadyante, right? If we surrender to Krishna, then we can overcome the modes of material nature. And ultimately, knowledge leads to surrender. And now, Krishna talks about then later about those people who surrender, but not to Krishna. They have this idea of surrender, but not to Krishna, and they surrender to demigods. So even that was discussed. The four types of people who go to Krishna. And then those who surrender, but not to Krishna, but someone else. They surrender to demigods. But their destination, however, is not Krishna. Those who do not surrender to Krishna, they will not go to Krishna. They will go to the destination of a particular devata they surrender unto. Okay. So then he also talks about how people perceive him, that they think that he was impersonal previously. And now he has assumed the personality. They do not know properly. And he talks about impersonalists. And he is not manifest to everybody because people are covered by yoga maya. Mudoyam nabijanati. Muda means fools. They do not know him. And then he says he knows about everything. But they do not know him. Lokoma majamavyayam. And he called those people as abuddhayaha. I mean, those who do not have intelligence. Those people who think like that, these are the impersonalists, the Mayavadis. Okay. And then he says he knows everything about everybody. And he again talks about this Icha Dvesha Samuttena Dvandva Mohena Bharata. Now, I told you to pay attention to one of the words previously. Daivi Hesha Gunamai Mamaya Duratya Mameva Prapadyante Maya Metam Tarantite. But even before that, the verse before, he talked about moha. Mohitam nabi janati. Because of the tribir gunamair bhavai evi sarvamidam jagat, mohitam nabi janati. Moha, they are bewildered. Okay. So now Krishna is coming back to this idea of this bewilderment. Okay. So this moha, of course, we have seen maya, pahrita jnana also, whose intelligence is stolen by maya. So now coming back to this idea of moha, how can they know Krishna? Iccha dvesha samuttena dvandva mohena bharata sarva bhutani sammoham sargya yanti paratapa. So they can know Krishna only if we surrender to Krishna. But those who are in moha, they cannot know Krishna. Of course, we can only know Krishna through bhakti, through devotional service. Now there are people who cannot take up devotional service because they are bewildered by dualities. Dvandva mohena bharata. Now, if you notice, in the previous verse, yesterday's class, there was dvandva moha was discussed. And in today's verse also, there is dvandva moha. Okay. So these people, those who are freed from dvandva moha, then they can worship the Lord. Then what are the characteristics of dvandva moha that was discussed yesterday? Does anyone remember? I don't know how many of you attended yesterday's class.
We were all here, but it looks like we didn't absorb as much as you expected us to.
Okay, we can.
I remember Mataji Gitamala at the end of the whole class saying she's in hell. So,
but that explains it all for you. That's what I...
What did you say at the end?
I said, no, he's saying I said something that I was in hell. But I think it's we are bewildered by the dualities, right? I mean, those who are
yes. Brahmamoha. Yes, bewildered by dualities of desire and hate. Ichha dvesha samuttena dvandva mohena bharata. I hope the summary helped you. How Krishna is, you know, talking about different things in this chapter. If you are just reading one verse, it may seem we don't understand how they are connected. But hopefully now you can see he started with, he is going to teach the yoga of taking shelter of him. Okay. And then he talked about, you know, what everything is coming from him and how we are trapped in this maya and we are bewildered, mohitam. And when we surrender to him, we get out. And he talked about those who surrender, those who do not surrender, those who surrender to someone else. And then how he talked about then he's not revealed to everybody and he's giving the reason. The reason is we are bewildered by desire and hate. These are the two things. Very, very, very dangerous. Ichha and dvesha. So what happens? We desire something. When we don't get what we want, then we become angry. And that anger turns into hate. Suppose if somebody doesn't behave according to our desires, their behavior is disturbing the way we want, the way we desire. And what happens? We are angry at that person and eventually that anger turns into hate. We hate that person so much that we don't want to hear about that person. Don't talk about him. Don't talk about her. And this duality, we are bound by this duality, by this ichha and dvesha. All living entities are born into delusion. Then what is the hope? If we are all, everybody is born into this. And previously in verse number 13, idam jagat, deluded by three modes, the whole world does not know me. Whole world is deluded by the three modes. And here all living entities are born into delusion. I mean, it's such a depressing thing. That's our condition. Then what do we need to do to get out of it? And how can we take shelter of Krishna if that is our situation? So much difficult situation. I don't know, it may be easy for all of you, but I fight with the modes every single day. Fighting with the material modes feels so hard. I think, why doesn't Krishna just give me so much love for him that I don't think of anything else but him and feel so, you know, lovingly towards him, towards everybody. You know, why should I be under these dualities? Do any of you think like that?
All the time.
I haven't thought about it the way you're thinking about it. Why won't Krishna just release me off all this bond? But I recognize how much I'm always under the modes and I'm always fighting and trying to escape it. And it's always dragging me back in,
yes. You know, yeah,
especially yeah. In the mind, you know, in the mind.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yes. It's such a big fight. It's such a big fight.
Mm-hmm. It's, and... you know, it's the dilemma of life, you know, and I believe we are lucky because at least we know there's something we have to do when we have to try hard. There's majority of the world that are roaming around just thinking, this is it. You know what I mean? And some of us, at least, we are lucky. Even if we are not there, we are fighting to get there, you know, and get liberation.
Yes. So the first step is recognition. Recognition to be able to separate illusion from reality, right? So it's very important. You mentioned an important point. A lot of people, they just think that the ignorance is bliss. And they think they see the world upside down. In the mode of ignorance, we consider religion to be religion and irreligion to be religion. What is good, they think it's bad. What is bad, they think it's all right, right? So that confusion exists. But when there is a little bit of enlightenment, then you can see that, yes, this is right, this is wrong, right? Gita Malamatiji, are you going to say something?
No, I was just thinking today in one of the meetings, somebody said, oh, I miss all the happy hours after PI planning or something like that. And I was thinking, I'm so glad I'm working from home and I don't miss any of those things, nor do I have to even pretend to go to those things.
Yes, you are probably thinking, you call it, you know, happy hour?
Exactly.
What an ignorance.
You know, most of the people think those are the things that are like, they're missing all the enjoyable things in this pandemic, you know.
Yes. Whereas
for me, I'm having a blissful time in all the Zoom calls and not going to any of these things.
Yes.
And you see, the thing is, like me, not too long ago, last year, the years before, even some part of this year, that was me, you know what I mean? I had no idea. It took just a day and a minute for everything to just start shifting. And I had no idea that, you know, like you cannot be looking at life in the material existence and always chasing material things. And when you don't have it, you're stressed up about it for some reason. Mm-hmm. No, I'll go look for the material things, but I'm not going to worship it to the extent that it stresses me out when I don't have it, you know? And just not too long ago, I didn't even know that.
Mm-hmm.
And I know most of the people I know don't know that. You know what I mean?
Yes.
So,
and even when we know, there are different levels of knowing, right? So there is intellectual understanding.
Absolutely.
But that understanding has to deepen. For example, in my case, okay, you know, I read different books in Shastra. I know what it should be, but I feel bad. I cannot be that, you see? So then that's the next level. That means the knowledge has to sink in into our chitta, into our consciousness and go deep. And it has to inspire us naturally to do the right thing, which is to surrender to the Lord, which is to behave like a devotee, to think like a devotee, right? So those things, then how do we get there, right? How do we get there? So that's what we will discuss today. We can, Prabhupada, there's a very beautiful purport here that we can see. So now, worshipping Krishna with determination, engaging in the service of the Lord with determination. This is Dhrida Vrataha. Vrata means vow. Okay? Vrata means vow. Dhrida means, holding on to it strongly. Okay. So Dhrida Vrata, we take our vows very, very seriously. Because like we're talking like this when we are knowledge, like you're saying, Kwaku, like, you know, my life last year or even some time of this year was not the way I want it to be, not the way I want now. Mm-hmm. It was not what I desire now. But even what you're desiring now, it's very hard to keep up because, you know, your mind becomes dull when you're tired, then again, you're attracted to certain things. But how can we be determined? Dhrida Vrata. How, first of all, you have to decide what your vow should be, what your resolution should be, what your New Year resolution, what your festival resolutions, what those should be, and then how we can be strongly situated in those things. Dhrida Vrataha. So that, but only those who are Dhrida Vrata, they can be free from these delusions. And there are two things here. We'll have a cyclical aspect going on here. If you recollect verse number 14, what did Krishna say? Those who surrender unto me, they can overcome this Maya. Okay? Those who surrender unto me, they can cross beyond this Maya, cross beyond the influence of this material world, which is made of three modes. But in this verse, he says, those who have acted piously and whose sinful actions are completely eradicated and who are freed from the dualities, they can engage in my service with determination. Did you catch the point? If you surrender to Krishna, you'll be free. But when you are free, then you can engage with determination. Did you get the point, all of you? Did you notice this?
Yes, we noticed it, but surrender is the key word, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, but it seems like you cannot really surrender strongly unless you are pious, unless you are free from sins, unless you are free from dualities. Okay? But you can only be free from those things if you surrender to Krishna. Okay? So then there's something going on here. How do we understand this aspect? So in the purport, Srila Prabhupada explains various things. So now Prabhupada here talks about those who are sinful, atheistic, foolish, deceitful. Asuram bhavam ashritaha, mudaha, mudoyam nabhijanati, and the deceitful. These are cheating type of people whose knowledge is stolen. Papaha, those who are sinful. For them, very difficult to transcend the duality of desire and hate. Ichchadvesha. So we have those who have acted piously, and through their pious activities, they refrain from sinful activities, and reactions to sinful activities also, they overcome because of their pious nature. They can accept devotional service. Now, there's a very technical thing in here. Does this mean the eligibility for bhakti is punya karyas? You do some pious activities. For example, one of the pious activities is you plant trees. You provide water facilities to people. You give some charity. These are all pious activities. But are they the criteria for bhakti to be able to get devotion to the Lord? Is our pious activities the source of bhakti?
Oh. You mean to say it's a prerequisite? Yeah.
Yeah, is that a prerequisite for bhakti?
No.
But here it appears so. Yesham tvantagatam papam jananam punya karmanam te dvandvamoha nirmukta bhajante mam dridavrataha. So then what is the role of these things? So the role of these piety and these activities is, yes, it will clear some ignorance. It will bring clarity. Then what happens is, in the next purport, it is described. Okay. And one more thing I want to mention in here before I go there. Those who have passed their lives in practicing regulative principles of religion, who have acted piously and who have conquered sinful activities, can accept devotional service and gradually rise to the pure knowledge of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So pay attention to the word Srila Prabhupada is using. Okay. So by regulated devotional service, what will happen? Pure knowledge. Then gradually they can meditate in trance on the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
So it's a stepping stone.
Yes. So in here, now I put that aside, that aspect of whether pious activities will give bhakti. I'll come to that in the second paragraph, but there's something else Prabhupada mentioned here. I wanted to bring your attention to this as well, because this type of explanation is usually hidden. It's not easy to figure out what's going on here. So regulative principles of religion and then gradually rise to knowledge. Knowledge means jnana. Meditation means dhyana. So you do some activities, you do karma yoga, it will bring you to the point of jnana yoga and then dhyana yoga. So this is very important. Pay attention to this. when we act in devotional service, whether it is cooking for Krishna, cleaning for Krishna, doing pujari services, all of these activities are as good as how much we are doing it for Krishna. But in order to understand that we are doing them for Krishna, we need to have proper knowledge to be able to discern from, oh, Sunday feast is not for me, it's for Krishna. That knowledge has to be there. When the knowledge is there, then the meditation comes. Otherwise, activities remain on the platform. Activities should evoke knowledge in us. Why am I doing this? A lot of times, okay, you're asking me to do, but Prabhu, I'm so busy, I cannot do it. So we become angry, then we think, hold on, who am I? Devotee of Krishna. Why am I being asked to do the service, to serve the Lord? Okay, can I figure out, I may be able to do, I may not be able to do. But what should be my attitude? Should I be angry? Should I feel depressed? How should I resolve this in my mind? I'm doing it for Krishna, but you know what? I'm sorry, I have something else. How we respond to the situation? So this knowledge builds a proper attitude in us. And when the proper attitude is there, it becomes conducive for meditation. Okay? Then gradually they can meditate in trance on the Supreme Personality of Godhead. What is being done? What is the knowledge surrounding what is being done? And how it is taking me to the meditation on the Lord. So then our service becomes so perfect. Mother Yashoda, when she is churning butter for the Krishna, she is singing of Krishna's glories. I don't know how many of you seen that. You know, when my daughter was little, she pretty much almost every day she used to watch one video. I don't have TV anymore. We had TV and I had a cassette of this thing or a DVD. I don't remember. Like Kana, oh Kana, why do you trouble me so much? So she's churning the butter and she's singing this song. There was a video. And every single day, you know, my daughter used to sit there and watch. She was like 2 or 3. So when Mother Yashoda and the gopis, they're performing activities, they're thinking of Krishna constantly. So we may be doing it a task, you know, Excel spreadsheet task. You're doing service Monday, Tuesday, I'm doing this day, this day, this day. It's a task for us. But when it becomes time for meditation on Krishna, then it starts becoming bhakti. Okay, that is the process of being situated on the spiritual platform. Now, this elevation is possible in Krishna consciousness in the association of pure devotees, for in the association of great devotees, one can be delivered from delusion. So the key point I'm coming to here is, what gives us bhakti is actually, according to Nectar of Devotion, we come to bhakti, we become attracted to bhakti because of previous bhakti. It's a great answer. We come to bhakti because of previously performed bhakti. In our previous lives, we have done it. So then, well, how does that happen in the previous lives? So we come to bhakti because we are favored by pure devotees, by the association of devotees. Not just association, but the mercy of devotees. Guru Krishna Prasade Paya Bhakti Lata Bija. We come to bhakti because of the mercy of pure devotees. But pure devotees give mercy to pious people. Unless we have this tendency, to do something good, and it also comes through Ajnata Sukruti. Means we have performed some unknowingly some pious activity. So those who are inclined to do pious activities, they may unknowingly also serve a pure devotee. And then they come to the platform of bhakti. So someone may have some charitable disposition and they may do that to a pure devotee. Then they develop Ajnata Sukruti. And through that, they'll get more association and mercy of devotees. And when devotees show their mercy, then Krishna gives his mercy. Oh, my devotee is favoring this person, so let me give this mercy. Krishna bhakti is never something that we can demand and never something that we think we are eligible for it. It simply comes through the mercy of devotees. Hiranyakashipu says to Prahlad, how did this happen to you? Where did you develop this mati, this attitude of Krishna? What was that verse in Srimad Bhagavatam, 7th canto? Aisham matim tavadurukramangrim prushatyanartopa. Does anyone remember? Is it 7-5 something? Yeah, 7-5-32. Aisham matis tavadurukramangrim sprashatyanathapagamo yadattaha mahiyasam padarajobhishekam nishkinchananam navrinitayavat. Why is Prahlad Maharaj speaking this verse? Because Hiranyakashipu asks him. Let's see, what did Hiranyakashipu ask? When Hiranyakashipu received this reply from the teachers, he again addressed his son Prahlada. Hiranyakashipu said, Bhuya ahasurasutam nached guru mukhi naamte kuto kupo kuto abhadra sati matihi. Where did you get this abhadra asati mati? For him, Krishna consciousness is abhadra, inauspicious, asati, very bad inclination. This is Hiranyakashipu. Demon see things upside down. Where did you get this abhadra mati? Asati mati. But actually, this is Bhadramati and Satmati. And see the word Mati in here. And Prahlad Maharaj says, oh, my dear father, this Mati you're talking about, Na Esha Mati, this kind of Mati that I have, you will not get it. Tavadurukramangim sprushatyanatta anattapagamo yadartha mahiyasam padarajobhishekam Nishkincha naam naam na vrinita yavat. Yavat means as long as we do not take shelter, we do not take bath, we do not perform abhisheka with pada raja. Raja means dirt. Dirt from the feet of mahiyasam, nishkincha naam mahiyasam. Those great souls who have nothing else but Krishna as their object of service. Until we bathe in the dust of their lotus feet, we will not develop attraction for the lotus feet of Krishna. Our consciousness, this mati, urukramangim sprishati, it will not even touch the lotus feet of the Lord. Our consciousness will not touch the lotus feet of the Lord until we take dust of the lotus feet of great devotees who have nothing else but Krishna as their object of love. That's what will give us bhakti. Nothing else will give us bhakti. We don't deserve bhakti. It is because Srila Prabhupada has kindly desired that we become devotees. Because of his desire, Krishna is favoring us. Otherwise, absolutely no hope, at least for me. I don't know about others here. I'm fully convinced that for me, no. Like Kwaku was saying, 1 year ago, half year ago, I was, 20 years ago, my life was totally different. It's not possible. So bhakti, even though we are performing some pious activities, we should not think that I am doing something pious activity, therefore I deserve to be a devotee. No, we don't deserve to be a devotee. When somebody said, Srila Prabhupada, I'm so fortunate that I came to Krishna consciousness. Prabhupada said, no, I gave you the fortune to be Krishna conscious. You didn't have the bhagya. We don't have the bhagya. It is the mercy of devotees. And that is what Prabhupada is saying. This elevation is possible in the association of pure devotees. But this becomes possible. This can be recognized by those who are pious. If you are sinful, it is very hard to recognize the mercy of the pure devotees also. So there has to be some. So Prabhupada said, I saw some spark and I fanned that spark. And that spark is that little punya, that little tendency to do something good. But if you want to be determined, then we have to be very careful. This is the process. One have to accept that, follow the regulative principles of religion. We must follow the instructions. Then only determination will come. If you are not avoiding sinful activities, then determination in bhakti will not come. A pure devotee will give the mercy, but we have to follow the instruction of the pure devotee and stay away from sinful activities. We have to do our best and we have to pray that, please help me, Krishna. Please help me, Prabhupada. And Prabhupada says in the second paragraph, in Srimad Bhagavatam 552, it is stated that if one actually wants to be liberated, he must render service to the devotees. Mahat sevam dwara mahur vimuktehe. Dwara means door. The door for liberation opens when we engage in the service of pure devotees. Service to pure devotees, the gates for liberation are opened. Tamodvaram yoshitam sanghi sangam. The gates to hell are open when we associate with materialistic people. Association with materialistic people is like drinking poison. And drinking poison means killing ourselves. And that poison is slow poison. It poisons us a little bit every day. Poisons our mind, poisons our intelligence, poisons our senses. And it drowns the soul in this poison. And it leads to hell. Tamodvaram yoshitam sanghi sangha. Now, in order to help us to get out of this, that is the job of pure devotees. All the devotees of the Lord traverse this earth just to recover the conditioned souls from their delusion. Now, this particular statement by Srila Prabhupada is also coming from Srimad Bhagavatam. Vishnor Bhutani Bhutanam Vishnor Bhutani Bhutanam Pavanani Charantihi Bhutanam Pavanaya Charantihi Vishnor Bhutani Bhutanam Pavanaya Charantihi. This is what Srila Prabhupada is paraphrasing. Srila Prabhupada's purports are so wonderful, beautiful, that they are simply repetition of what acharyas and scriptures have said. Just that one sentence. I was so amazed. That one sentence. Srimad Bhagavatam 11:2:28. Maharaja Nimi is speaking this to Navayogendras. Vishnor Bhutani Lokanam Pavanaya Charantihi. Vishnoho Bhutani, the servants of Vishnu, of all the worlds, purification, they move about. The pure devotees of Lord Vishnu wander throughout the universe, not for their personal selfish interest, but to purify all the conditioned souls. Now look at this here. The devotees of the Lord traverse this earth just to recover the conditioned souls from their delusion. So Prabhupada is citing the words of Maharaja Nimi from Srimad Bhagavatam 11th canto. And not only that, in the Gopi Gita, gopis are saying, what is this? Bhuridajana, tavakatamritam tapta jivanam kavibiriritam kalmashapaham divibhunantiye. What is that? Does anyone remember? Bhuvigrananthiye Bhuridajana. Yes. These pure devotees, they wander the universe. Bhuvigrananthiye Bhuridajana. Tavakatamritam taptajivana. The messages of the Lord, it will purify us from this miseries of this material world. Tava kathamritam tapta jivanam. And that is the purpose of the pure devotees, because if we want to come out of the miseries of the material existence, the only hope is the mercy of the pure devotees. By giving us Krishna katha, they purify our existence. The more we hear about Krishna, the more our hearts are purified. Shunvatam svakata Krishna punya shavana kirtanah hridyantasto hya badrani vidnoti surutsata. Krishna shunvatam svakata Krishna punya shavana kirtanah hridyantastah abadrana abadrani vidnoti. Hridyantastaha, hridi antastaha. There is somebody who is in our heart. That person is Krishna. Krishna is in your heart, my heart, and everybody's heart. But until and unless we bring Krishna from outside into inside, the inside Krishna will not help us unless we bring Krishna from outside. What does this mean? That means Krishna is there in his katha, in his glories, in his glorification. When we hear the glories of the Lord, then Krishna from inside will start cleaning our heart. Because when you hear the glories of the Lord, we are expressing Krishna who is inside, that Krishna, I am interested in you. Then the Krishna from within, he starts purifying our heart. Vidanoti suhrut sada. Then what happens at that time? Tada rajastamo bhava kama lobada yashtaye chetaye tairana vidham sitam satve prasidati. The lower modes of ignorance and passion, we come out of those modes when Krishna purifies us from within. But Krishna will purify us from within when we hear from outside. Where will we hear from? We hear from the mouths of pure devotees. The nectar coming from the mouths of Satam Prasangam Mamavirya Samvido Bhavanti Hritkarna Rasayana Kata Tajoshanada Shvapavarga Vartmani Shreddharatir Bhaktir Anukramishyati. Satam Prasangam Mamavirya Samvido, Kapila Devi is telling to Devahuti. My glories, they become very tasty. Satam prasangan mamavirya samvido bhavanti hrit karana rasayana. They are pleasing to the heart, they are pleasing to the ears. Krishna katha, in the association of devotees. And that will make us shraddha ratir bhaktir anukramishyati. That will give us shraddha, that will give us attraction, that will make us dhridavrata in bhakti, determined in bhakti. So the only formula always is to take shelter of the pure devotees. Adau Guruvashrayam. There is no other way other than taking shelter of pure devotees. That's the only process to be able to become dhridavrata. Determination is possible when we are in the association of devotees, we are determined. As soon as we are out of devotees association, then it doesn't work. Because when we are in the association of devotees, we amplify each other. In the material mathematics is, if 1 plus 1 becomes 2, but spiritual mathematics is 1 plus 1 is 4. Because if when we both come together, you become double, I become double. This is the beauty of Krishna consciousness. And when pure devotees association, it is much more purifying. Even though we are not pure devotees, if we just do something together as devotees, we can feel the amplification. So therefore, association of devotees is the principle to be determined, and that gives a determination. And in that process, then we can be free from all sinful tendencies. Any other process, it may make us free from the results of sin, but it doesn't make us immune to not performing sinful activities again. So you may have other process. For example, the government may put restrictions that if you get intoxicated, then I'll punish you. Then out of fear, you may stop. But as soon as there is no restriction, we'll start again. So you may say that, oh, government is helping me not perform sinful activities. But the tendency to perform sinful activities is not going away. Only bhakti can destroy the tendency to perform sinful activities. So therefore, the single most principle is sadhu sangha, sarva shastra kahe, kahe lava matra sadhu sangha, sarva siddhi hoye. That's it. Very simple. So our prayer should be, Krishna, somehow or other, keep me in the association of devotees. Association of those devotees who will inspire me in bhakti, and so that I never have to see this material existence again. That's the only hope. So I'll stop here. Any questions or comments from anyone?
Prabhu, there's another verse about serving the devotees and getting affinity towards Krishna. Sushrusho Shadda Dhanasya Vasudeva Kataruchi Shran Mayat Sevaya Vipra Punya
Nishevana. Yes, very nice. Thank you. Yes. I think it is in the same series of verses. Second chapter. First canto, I believe. First canto, second chapter. That's it. Sushrusho Shadda Dhanasya Vasudeva Kataruchi. And that particular verse is actually also saying that if we want taste to hear about Krishna, right? So I think it precedes that other verses. By hearing Krishna Katha, then Krishna is purifying us. But how do you develop taste for Krishna Katha? So taste for Krishna Katha comes by serving devotees. When we shushrusho shraddha dhanasya vasudeva kataruchi syan mahat sevaya, by mahat seva, then we develop interest to hear about Krishna Katha. So if you don't feel like, reading Prabhupada's books and hearing this and that, that means we have to perform some service to a pure devotee. And that pure devotee will give us inclination for hearing Krishna Katha. Thank you, Mataji. Very important verse. Any other comments, questions from anyone?
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna, Kwaku, Prabhu, yes.
So I remember you said something, it's just a comment that I had, because earlier on in the beginning, you had said something about even those who are in the path of knowledge, they need bhakti, something of that sort, right? Mm-hmm. And I just wanted to add to that, because I was watching a video, the other day, and it was these people, they were talking about, Advaita Vedanta, Vivekananda, that group, they were showing a video about the path of knowledge. And the guy was saying that you cannot be on a path of knowledge. I think it's called Gani. He said, you cannot be on a path of knowledge without bhakti. It is impossible. So for anybody that wants to be on a path of knowledge, bhakti is the beginning. You have to have been a devotee before even that path of knowledge becomes successful for you. So I just want to say, even those who, that is their philosophy, the path of knowledge, they admit that their path is not successful unless they embark on bhakti.
Yes, that's true.
And he was saying that to do meditation, you need karma yoga to clear off all the impurities in your mind. Once you have a pure mind, then you can have a steady mind and meditate. But for Gani, I don't know if it's Ghana or Gani. I think it's Gani, right?
Yes. You can say Gnani and you can say Dhyani. Dhyana Gani. Means meditation. Dhyana means knowledge.
Okay, I'll get the words soon. But you know what I'm talking about. So you're saying for that, bhakti is foundation before God will even, you know, open up the doors for the knowledge to come to you.
Yes, Vasudeve Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojitaha Janayatyasu Vairagyam Jnanam Chedahaitukam. Actually, bhakti gives birth to true knowledge and renunciation. They come through knowledge. So the sequence, what I was saying about Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, Dhyana Yoga is, I was saying even within the process of bhakti, when we are performing activities, when we do those activities with proper knowledge, there is more benefit. And when we do those activities through meditation, when we are meditating on Krishna, when we are doing those activities, then it is higher. Yeah. So we have to have knowledge of why I'm doing this. And also we have to meditate on Krishna, that Krishna, I'm doing this to you for your pleasure. And then it turns into love, and that's the highest state. Not just mechanical, right? From mechanical, we need to do through knowledge, and we need to do with contemplation. Activity, and then proper information, and then it goes to contemplation, and then the feelings get invested in it. Then love of God, you know, will follow.
Okay. And then the doors open up for proper knowledge to come in.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. All we need to do is hang around, be with devotees. That's all.
This Lava Matra Sadhu Sangha is such a critical line, you know, it is so true.
Yes, and we have to remind ourselves about that, you know, all the time, all the time. Yeah.
So Prabhu, I have a question. How do you serve pure devotees who are not in the material world, like Bhakti Siddhanta Maharaj or Gaur Govind Maharaj or, you know, Bhakti? Mm-hmm. All these, Prabhupada, I know by serving his mission, you're serving him.
Yes. We can follow their instructions. You know, Vani Seva, Vapu Seva. We can hear, we can read their scriptures and what they are instructing and try to follow their instructions. That is also a way to serve and share those instructions with others if possible. So that's how we serve the Purva Acharyas, because the goal of all the Purva Acharyas is to propagate this mission, and they're happy. Prabhupada was one time, one devotee was chanting. He was so happy. Oh, you are chanting? Very nice. He was happy if devotees were chanting. He was happy if devotees were reading his books. So same thing. We follow the instructions of the previous Acharyas and they'll be happy. That's also a service.
Thank you, Prabhu.
Thank you. Okay, so we'll stop here on the devotees. Thank you for your association. Vancha kalpatarubhyascha kripa sindubhyascha evacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namaha.
Vaishnavi ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Srinivasacharya Prabhu ki jai. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, everyone.
Hare Krishna, everyone.